Hello, everybody. It's Mary Janet here. I've never done this before, and I just want to welcome each and every one of you to my Cape Breton kitchen. And I want to say hi to my own children, Tammy, Brennan, Margie, Gordy, Kelly, Krista, and Mitchell, and all the grandkids, and all the daughters-in-law, and sons-in-law, and fiancés. I just have to get everybody in there. So I'm not going to be reading all the notes that you're sending when you're as you're joining. I'm just going to look at that while the cinnamon rolls are baking. Now I'm just going to pretend that there's one person watching me, and I am going to go ahead and start. The very first thing, of course, in the name of hygiene, I'm going to go and wash my hands. So I hope you did the same thing. Now, the very other next thing that you have to do is preheat your oven. I cook mine at 425 degrees. Just who you are, where you're from, and at the end of the whole thing, maybe you could send me a picture in the notes and with one of your cinnamon rolls, and hope to God that they turn out nice for you. Okay, so if everybody's ready, I'm going to get started here. And I know Margie, my daughter Margie, she got me into this. But you know what? I'm kind of happy. In this day and age and all of this, you know, close proximity to people, it's a nice way to visit. And maybe we'll do it again next week. But I'll start from here. There's so many good cooks out there. Everybody could take a turn. So I'm going to start with my cinnamon rolls. These poor cinnamon rolls, they started, how these kinds started was back when the kids were in little, all seven of them. I mean, money was tight and all of that. And I remember one time buying a little can of Pillsbury cinnamon rolls, and they had the nice little can at the end. They probably still make them, I don't know, with the frosting. And of course, everybody loved them, but there was always so many kids. So I said, why can't I do that myself? I'll make my own cinnamon rolls and I'll put frosting on them. And it just became a little popular thing and something that I'd get up early in the morning and make before the kids went to school, and it was cheap, and put it in their lunch. And so anyway, I'm gonna get started right now. Now, you see here, I hope you can see that, I have pre-measured my flour. That's the only thing I've pre-measured. I know you guys have other things pre-measured and done, but I just wanted to put this much a head start for myself. So there's 4 cups of flour in here. So I'm going to add to that 6 teaspoons of baking powder. You can use magic baking powder. I think I got it at No Frills, but I usually kind of like to get the kind that's sold at our local co-op. It's just the bulk kind, but this is just as good. Okay, 6 teaspoons of baking powder and 2 teaspoons of salt. And 2 tablespoons of white sugar. You can kind of make them heaping. This is not about watching your calories, this recipe. I mix it with my hands. So just give it a good mix. Can you all see that? I'm seeing the comments, so I don't know if you can see all of that. That's all you do. You just mix that up. And talking about things that aren't so diet friendly. Margie's boyfriend calls this the carb coast. I'm a perfect example of that. So when I'm cutting up the shortening, I just use the measurement on the box and I cut up to the measure there of a half a cup, okay? Maybe a little more, that's okay too. And again, I am mixing this with my hands. If you have one of those other things, this is the old-fashioned way of doing it. So I'm just gonna do this. How's everybody doing anyway? I hope you're okay. So, I don't know. I think my son just sent me a text message and I missed it. I probably forgot to say something and I forget. I hope you know that I'm Mary Janet and we're making cinnamon rolls. I don't know what he was saying. He only lives over the road. He should just run over and tell me. But we're social distancing these days. I hope you're all feeling good and safe and all of that. So you're going to mix these all up until they're, Mitchell just texted me, the measurements. Okay, so we started off with 4 cups of flour, 6 teaspoons of baking powder, 2 teaspoons of salt, 2 heaping tablespoons of white sugar, and 1/2 cup of shortening. Now, I think Margie already in the post laid out the recipe, so you should be able to look back at that post if it was shared and see that that's the recipe for it. Okay, so you just mix that until you don't feel any of the pieces of shortening anymore. I wonder if Dwight is watching out there in Fort McMurray. That's Tammy's dog that was on the talking video the other night. I'm telling you, that was hilarious. Okay, I'm pretty much done that part. Hope you are too. I just want you to see the consistency. It's just kind of what they refer to as mealy. And this is the exact same recipe that I use for the dough part for making my biscuits. The same exact thing. You just don't roll it out as thin as you do for cinnamon rolls when you're making the biscuits. And I'll show you that in a minute. Okay, now that that's all nicely done, hope I'm not going too fast for anybody. Okay, so I just make a little well in the center, okay, so that I put all of the flour mixture up to the sides. And I have pre-measured here 2 cups of milk. It can be any kind of milk. I have used everything under the sun when I didn't have something. So one time, do you know what I used? We get the little tiny things that you put in your coffee, the cream. I used a whole bunch of creamers and then topped it up with water to make 2 cups. This, I have 1% milk in here, but I've used 2%. It doesn't matter, you can use whole milk and or mix up whatever cream you have with water to make 2 cups. So, with my fork, I'm just gonna take all of that down into the middle. I know some people say you can't handle it too much or they'll be tough, you know, whatever. But I just mix it around until there's no floury residue in the bottom. I'll show you in a minute. should be able to see this. Okay, that's done. And that's just what you have, a nice thick dough. So what I forgot to tell you, I always have a little bowl of flour on the counter ready to use. So I have my 1 cup bit of that I measure my flour with, and I just fill it with flour and I sprinkle as needed. So I'm just going to sprinkle a little bit on the counter. And this is probably this is the key part, all of this that's happening now to make your cinnamon rolls. So I'm going to put the batter in here. And after we get this in the oven, when we're done, I'm going to come back and I'm going to show you how I clean my bowl afterwards. I clean it with flour. Perhaps there's lots of good cooks out there that do the same thing, but I'm just going to do it for those that don't want to deal with a doughy bowl. I'll show you how to do that in a minute. So right now, after we added those 2 cups of flour and we have our dough, I'm just going to bring it together into a nice round. Dough ball here. So, see that? And that, my friends, is biscuits. You can make biscuits from there. You want it to stop there and just make good old cake Breton biscuit. So I have my rolling pin and I'm going to add lots of flour to the rolling pin. Now, if I were making biscuits, I'd probably roll it about that thick. That's probably about up to my knuckle on my thumb thick. And I use a big biscuit cutter. I don't know what the measure is. It's probably about 3 inches wide. So it makes a big biscuit. But if you like smaller biscuits, the biscuit cutter that I use, which is not in the drawer, of course, you know the little cans of tomato sauce that you get, just use the tomato sauce and then cut the top and the bottom off it and wash it out, and that's the perfect size. Make sure you don't use that can opener that takes the whole rim off. You want that rim on, and that makes a nice, probably a 2-inch biscuit, whatever your preference is. But now we're making cinnamon rolls, so I am going to I kind of lift my dough up and I put a little flour underneath it as I'm rolling it out. And put more flour on your rolling pin. And now I'm gonna try to make it like in more of a rectangle, because you're gonna be rolling this up. There, that's about right. So I'm trying to measure with my fingers here. I should have, I'd say about to the end of your nail, of your ring finger or your middle finger there. It's about how thick it is. It's probably, I'm guessing at 1/2 inch. I just kind of guess at that. So now, to go back, just hold on a second. So to go back over that recipe again, it was 4 cups of flour, 6 teaspoons of baking powder, 2 teaspoons of salt, 2 heaping tablespoons of white sugar, and I use 1/2 cup of shortening. Many people use butter, real butter, go for it and make it in their biscuits. You use whatever you want to use. And for this next part, I just use bay sale. It's just so easy and it's always soft. I don't have to worry about it. And you use real butter. And I'm just gonna go wash my hands off. I'm all full of sticky, but powdery flour and shortening and batter. This is where you'll run into, you don't know how much, because I don't measure this part, so you're gonna have to just watch, okay? So I'm using basil. I'm just gonna put a few dollops on here. Once I start spreading it out with my hands, I'll know whether I'm doing it right, I have enough on it or not. So I just wipe it over, kind of like when you're spreading peanut butter on a sandwich. That's how much butter you want to have. Hope you all can hear me okay. Am I speaking loud enough? Okay. All right. Can y'all see that? So, Mitchell says to turn the small light off. How's that? Is that better? But I'm just gonna take this little tripod over here. I want you to see how that it's going. Okay. And yes, Margie, I told them at the beginning to preheat the oven. You weren't watching. My kids are texting me, telling me things I forgot, but I did tell you, preheat the oven to 425, and I have propane oven, and it's different. All ovens are different. She just wasn't listening, and she's a teacher. Anyway, okay, now, butter first, basil, whatever. We're done with that for now. And now comes the brown sugar. And I don't know how much. I'm just gonna put some on and then I'll know if I have enough. So take any lumps out, you know, and then just spread it over to the edges. And I mean, it depends on how many circles you want in your cinnamon rolls. I like mine a little bit thicker, but you can probably roll it out to a quarter inch and have more rings in it, okay? That actually was just enough brown sugar. And just so you know, I'm not gonna turn this feed off while they're cooking. I'm gonna turn the music up. I have Natalie McMaster's new CD playing there. It's down low. And I'm gonna look at all the comments and talk to you, maybe. Or you can just listen to the music, you go put on a load of laundry, you can do whatever you want, because it's gonna take 18 minutes around to cook it in my oven. All right, so I'm sorry I can't read your comments. I'll be nervous if I see how many are out there. I have no idea how many there are. So this is my cinnamon, and there's a little shaker on it, just like pepper and whatever. And I just shake it over. Feels nice and cinnamony. I think that's about right. Now, I gotta wash my hands again, sorry. I got all kinds of sugar on me. All right, Oh my God, this is really fun. It's like having you in for tea. I'm gonna make tea, and I'm gonna have a hot cinnamon roll with you if you care to stay online and have a cup of tea with me, and a fresh cinnamon roll if you're cooking at the same time as me. All right, are we ready to start this? So I'm gonna start just, I'm picking up the edges and make that first roll. That's the hardest part, is that first roll. And if it gets sticky, you have that little dish of flour. Mine is looking pretty good. Normally it's sticky. I don't know. But anyway, I'm gonna roll them up. Look at that. Just perfect. Do you see that? Does everybody see that? She's gonna take this down. Okay. I don't know if that, I'm doing that right. Never done this before, as I said. We're just playing it by ear. Now, for this part, God, I lost my knife. What the heck did I do with that? It's gone. Hold on, I gotta go get another one. Okay, I use a nice bread knife, a serrated edge. And at this point, I have my pan all ready with my parchment paper on it. Now, I don't use just a metal cookie sheet. Years ago, when my daughter Tammy, out there in Fort McMurray, hi Tammy, was selling Pampered Chef, and I bought a stoneware pizza pan, and I can't remember what this one's called, but it's the size of a cookie sheet. And I'll tell you, it's really hard when you're dealing with a metal pan. You have to put the pan in the oven on the middle rack. But depending how your oven is, you have to really watch that they don't scorch on the bottom, because the sugar and the cinnamon will tend to do that. Having the parchment paper on your metal pan, that will help somewhat. And but I use the stoneware pan, and I find it's a gentler cook, and they don't really scorch on the bottom. So I'm gonna go ahead and start cutting the cinnamon rolls. And I cut the two ends off, and I might put them in the second time in the oven, just because I want them a nice size. So I cut them, I'm gonna say about 3/4 of an inch wide, and I gently saw them back and forth. Otherwise, they're kind of, the dough is squishing down, and you don't want that. So the first one is always kind of small, and you put it on your pan, and I let mine kind of, and if you don't have parchment paper, it's okay, you just use your cookie sheet. I wouldn't put foil, because foil will bring more heat. But I just got a message there about that. So if you don't have parchment paper, go with what you have. Or even, you know what else I used before? Sometimes I'll make the recipe and I'll times and a half everything. You know, instead of 4 cups of flour, I put 6 cups in. And that'll give you a lot more if you're feeding a bunch more. And when that second bunch, I put in my glass Pyrex pan, you'd make a lasagna in, that size, and actually that worked really well. But of course, I think I did use parchment paper too. I love parchment paper. You know who introduced me to parchment paper many years ago was Mary Laurette Beaton in Mabu, the infamous chef that she is, and I've been using it ever since, and I would die without it, I'm telling you. It's great for putting on your pan when you're cooking, especially meat, and it's such an easier cleanup. So I'm putting these, you know, three across. They're barely touching, but they will be touching by the time they're cooked. This recipe will probably make maybe 15. I can't remember how many it makes, but it's around that. And maybe I'll just show you one. Can you see that? And the thickness. So it's about the up to that knuckle off my index finger. Just today, no matter where you are, there's so many bad things happening with this coronavirus, but today our province declared a state of emergency. And they're seriously, I didn't see it myself, the whole press release that our premier was on the air there, and encouraging no gatherings more than 5 people. And I guess there was also something said about the border, like we border New Brunswick. So I haven't seen it myself because I was getting ready. But anyway, it's a different world, isn't it? Okay. And one more. So I'm going to take that first little scrawny one off, and I'm going to put a nice big one in the corner. There. And I'll cook those later. So I'm just going to bring these over to you so you can see them before they go in the oven. I better hang on to the parchment paper or they'll slide down. Okay, so we have 15. Okay. So my oven rack is right in the middle, and I'm going to set my timer. I live by my timer, and I live mostly by recipes, except when I'm making stuff like this, I measure everything. Hold on a second. Okay, I put 18 on there, but around the 15 minute mark, I'd be checking them, and I'll just, you know, I can tell by the look of it, and I'll make sure you come over right to the oven with me so you can see what I mean. So now the best part of it all is cleaning up, but we have to make the frosting. But first, I'm going to clean that bowl. So the best way, I'm not supposed to be touching your face, sorry about that. The best way to clean a bowl that you have had dough in is by sprinkling a bit of flour in it, like that. And you just really hard rub back and forth, one section at a time. This is an old Tupperware bowl from years gone by. I have 2 of them. And it's just the best thing in the world. So I usually go all the way around. So all the dough part, your bowl is basically flour dry, and I just put it on the counter with the rest of the stuff that needs to be cleaned up. And I use my biscuit cutter to clean off my counter. Here now. Get my garbage can. I probably could be doing a lot better job, but you know what? this is what I do when I make them, so I'm not changing my ways just for you guys. There now, that's the bulk of the mess. Frosting. I'd really like to do a shout out here. I was asked this morning, somebody wanted to add some people, and I have no problem with that. And it's Kathy Beaton. Well, and formerly from Glencoe Mills, and she works at the NICU unit in Halifax, and she wanted to add some nurses on there that are up there. And I'm telling you, they have to go to work, all these nurses, and I just want to embrace every single nurse out there that is going through this, putting themselves at risk, I'm sure, but you have to go to work, and you certainly are appreciated, I can tell you that. Certainly by me and by many, many people. What else can I tell you? I think that's it for now, and I'm going to get my stuff for the frosting. So, again, you can use butter. I'm using basil because it's nice and soft and easy. So I don't have any measurements for this, because I never know how much it's going to make. What would that be? 3 tablespoons or so. A big dollop. And I can't afford the real vanilla. Somebody was telling me about vanilla. Oh yeah, I don't measure this either. I usually just put it in the cover. So I'm going to put, it's probably 2 teaspoons. Splash that in there. And what did I do? Okay, icing sugar. I'm going to guess around 2 cups. I have no idea, but I'll show you the, I think that's about enough. And then a little milk. Forget about buying that frosting in the store. You can make your own. Okay, that's it. You know everything's in there, vanilla, and the basil, and the icing sugar. And now I'm gonna get some milk. And I'm just gonna pour a little bit in. And I'll add icing sugar and milk depending on the consistency that I'm looking for. The consistency I am looking for is probably peanut butter again. That consistency, okay? So that's a little too dry. I'm gonna add some more milk. The other people I was thinking of, you know, that can't stay home, have to go to work, is the people in the grocery stores, you know? It's just, how in the world? Well, I guess they're taking all the precautions, but they're very much appreciated as well. All the cleaning staffs at the hospital, I'm telling you. Okay. I think that's about right. So, about that consistency, you can see that. And hopefully that is enough. So there, we're just gonna wait. I'm gonna keep you online because I'm scared to death that I'll ruin the whole thing if I turn you off. But what I'll do, I think I'll take it to the table, and I'm going to look at the comments, and if there was any questions, I'll try to look at that. I hope I can do that. Oh, don't worry about the angry face. God, I wouldn't even notice that. Don't be worried. I've done that before, too. So, there's 11 minutes left, so we're going to have a little time on our hands. And I might go and do something, who knows. But I'm going to bring you over here to my table. Hi. There you go. I'm going to turn the music up a little bit. Hope you like fiddle music. Okay. Just going to put it on a little bit. And I'm going to scroll through these messages. This is so fun. Well, you're welcome. I'm so glad. Hi, Lorianne. Laurel Brown. Oh my God. I don't even know how to scroll through these. I guess I can't. Oh my God, Fee McKenzie from Scotland. Hi. That's amazing. Okay, listen, it's so nice to have you in my kitchen. I wish I could give you a cup of tea. I'm just going to go turn the kettle on because I'm going to have a cup of tea. So, if you guys are interested, like, Margie just put that out just because everybody's kind of home and wondering, you know, like, what are we going to do with ourselves, you know? And I have terrible internet service. The technician is coming tomorrow, so I have to use data to do this because it's in and out. But anyway, Margie was suggesting, you know, let's do a photo challenge and get everybody involved. But then she suggested this idea of getting a few people together to do a recipe and just bring people together and have some fun, you know? And honest to God, it's a great thing. I love it, and I encourage you to do it with your own friends too, you know, like we should all be doing something like this. But I was thinking, what can I do? I'm going to bring you my recipe box. Hold on a second. I just have to tell you a little story. many years ago, Margie is the instigator of so many things, that the devil in her. But anyway, we started on Christmas time. Everybody had to make a homemade gift, whatever was, you know, good or bad or funny or whatever. I don't know how many years we've been doing it, but probably something like, I'm going to say 15 years, but maybe it's not that long. But in Mabu, where I was born and raised in Mabu, up behind the church in Mabu, for anybody that's ever been there, and our family used to gather up there, like back in the 1990s and into the 2000s, and way up in the mountain, the panoramic view is just amazing. But there was a big elm tree there, and the elm tree was living at that time. And we do have a picture from back in 1912, and you can see the elm tree was living then. It was a big tree then too. And one year we measured around, and it was with a string, and I think it was 18 feet around. So it was a pretty big tree. But over time, as the years went on in the 2000s, the tree finally died. And I was
trying to figure out what could we do this one Christmas for a homemade gift. So, there I go touching my face again, sorry. My husband and I went down to the tree after it had died and limbs had fallen around. I still have 25 acres there. And we went and we picked up some pieces of the old elm tree. And Cecil took it to one wood fella and another one planed it and whatever. And we ended up with some boards that were probably about 3/4 inch thick. And I got, the kids were, all the kids are wherever, all over Canada, living here or there, and they'd be calling all the time, what's the recipe for this and what's the recipe for that? So I found 3x5 inch index cards that you can put through the printer. There's three on a page. And I typed up all the recipes that they asked for and more, you know, between sweets and meals and drinks and God knows, dips, all those things. And I instructed Cecil, who is, you know, not a woodworker by any means, but him and his brother went and made recipe boxes for the kids out of the old elm wood tree. And then I got a little decal made called Elm Tree Recipes, because these kids and all the cousins from Michigan and all over used to gather and would have like a little family reunion up there every summer. So here is the recipe box, and it's called Elm Tree Recipes. And every one of the children were given one of these at Christmas. And inside are all the favorite recipes from mom and dad and some from their grandmothers. And, you know, it's just, and I have it on the counter all the time. I made one for myself, and I think my siblings all got one. There's nothing finished on it, but it was just a nice thing. So I suggest that you do that. If anybody's capable of doing that, it's a nice gift to your kids to give them what they grew up enjoying. And my kids used to trade off the homemade cookies and cinnamon rolls that I made for them for the store-bought cookies for their high school friends. I only found this out many years later, but pretty funny. And now they appreciate the work that went into making them early mornings and then go to work, right? So what's left in my timer here? Hold on a second. So we have about 3 minutes left, and and my kettle boiled. I'm going to go set the tea. If you're a true Cape Bretoner, you have to have King Cole tea. So I'm going to put 2 bags in the pot, and I'm going to put the hot water on it, and I'll be back to you in a minute. Okay, let's see. Oh, I was going to say one more thing. Natalie McMaster. Okay, so I call myself Natalie's aunt. She calls me her aunt because I was raised with her mom and their siblings when our mother died when she was only 37. So just last month, Natalie wanted to know if I would look after her social media platforms. So I'm looking after her Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube. Not doing a real good job on those other ones, but Facebook, I can handle that. So I'm asking a favor of all of you to find, type in Natalie McMaster, putting the Mac and the Master together at the last name, and like the page and start following it, because I want to up the numbers. And you'll look at some sweet videos that I've been able to post. She posted a beautiful one on St. Patrick's Day of her and her 7 children. And yesterday she posted, it was World Down Syndrome Day. She posted one of her dear little daughter, Sadie, who has Down syndrome. And it's just beautiful. So I encourage you to go watch that later. But this is her latest CD, and that's what's playing. So I'm just going to go put the tea on. I'll be right back. So guys, I talked too much and the cinnamon rolls were on the full 18 minutes, but you know what? It was perfect. I'll show you. I'm just seeing Anna's comment there. Hold on. Okay. I hope you can see. Can you see that? So they've got a little brown around the edges. They're just the perfect color. And I can tell like they're not burnt. Believe me, you can tell when they're burnt, okay? So I'm putting you back up here. Get your cookie rack out. I'm gonna put them on here. Oh my God, the smell. It's just so cinnamon and sugar. Can't beat that. So, truth be told, just a minute. Truth be told, I normally wouldn't frost them like right away when they come out of the oven. I'd probably wait about 3 or 4 minutes so that they're not really, really hot. Because when they're really, really hot, kind of when you're putting the frosting on, it'll kind of melt and go down in between, which is good too. But I'm gonna frost them right now. And you know what else? Do you see my apron? Don't you love my apron? This is Brenna McNeil. She sells these aprons and she sells all of this product. What is it under Miss Brenna on the internet? I think if you type in and Google Miss Brenna and you want something in Cape Breton like hoodies, we gave one to every one of our grandchildren. And I just love it. Miss Tennis? I don't think so, Margie. Margie's texting me there and she doesn't know how to type. It's Miss Brennis, I thought. Okay. So I use a knife and just scoop up a little bit and start spreading, just like you were spreading on bread. Oh my God, they smell so good. My tea is almost ready. I have to watch that it doesn't boil. But I have it on that low burner and you have to really watch it because you have to have steeped tea. That's the best kind. So, if you guys are open to this, any of you, one of the other popular things that I used to bake when the kids were going to school and still is a big favorite, they're called chocolate chip jumbles. They're just like a chocolate chip cookie, but they've rolled oats in them and whatever. And I was talking to Mitchell and his wife, Laura, they're over the road, three doors from me. And, you know, they have a nice, what do you call those counters in the middle of the kitchen, whatever that is. It'd be easy to look at you and bake at the same time. And they just redid their kitchen, so it's just beautiful. And, I was going to go over there next Sunday at the same time at 2:00 and make the chocolate chip jumbles with you. And all you need for that is chocolate chips and rolled oats, quick oats, whatever you want to call it. And we're going to make them. And then at another time to be determined, everybody loves porridge brown bread. I was going to try that as well. And my neighbor, Cassie, hi Cassie, if you're watching, I can see her house out my window. She makes the most beautiful cookies in the whole friggin' world. And we're gonna see if Cassie will do that. And her beautiful granddaughter there, Christy, will help her. Okay, this is just about done. So you can see that they're all kind of, they've expanded and they're touching one another. And what Andrea Beaton said, oh, darn it. Margie, send that message again, I missed it. I wasn't looking. I cut in between all of them before I scoop them out of the pan. Okay, I missed that message. There's something about Andrea Beaton. Andrea, the wicked fiddle player. So I've cut between every one of them. And the best ones are in the middle. So I'm going to just take this middle one out. And I'm going to show it. Can you smell that? Andrea Beat said, I want to do millionaire shortbreads. There now. There's a good plan. We just have to befriend her. Or no. If anybody wants to see this, you don't have to add me as a friend. Oh, I'm happy to have you as a friend. It's set on, what's it set on? Public. So there. There's your nice, warm, yummy cinnamon roll, Mary Janet style. And I'm going to pour myself a cup of tea, and I'm going to sit at the table. I'm going to have the first bite with you, and I'm just going to take you along with me here. Sorry if I'm disturbing you there, shaky. I'm going to pour my tea. I'll be right back. Best in a china cup or in one of Colton McDonnell's beautiful pieces of pottery. That's love that. Okay. Taste test. You know, the right way to eat a cinnamon roll is you go all around the outside and you leave the center one for the last bite. Okay, before I take this bite and a little slurp of tea, a little gillick, as would say in Gaelic, I would love if, when you make them, if you've made them today along with me, great, if you've just watched, but when you make them, I would love if you would take a picture of one of your cinnamon rolls, pick the best one, and yourself, and tell me, and put it in a message on this whole feed thing that's going on, and or on the post that I posted or Margie posted, and just tell me where are you from. That would be lovely. Let me see how this tastes. I wish you were here. That's really, really good. Okay, I'm gonna try to close this off, and hopefully I'll close it off the right way so that it will remain on my page, not having done this before. Oh, there's Colton McDonnell. Oh my God, there's so many beautiful people on here that I'm seeing their names. I love you all, and thank you for bearing with me, and hope you enjoyed it, and maybe we'll see you next Sunday. There's Darlene Sutherland. Have a good day, everybody. Stay safe and, wash your hands and love one another. Okay, bye.